Good morning and assalamu alaikum everyone. This is Sumaya Khalifa with the Islamic Speakers Bureau of Atlanta, welcoming you to our inspiration for this morning. I just wanted to share something that I ran into lately, and we talk about mindfulness, and mindfulness is being present, intentionally present in the moment, feeling what's going on and being intentional about being there. There is another word that is being used more and more now with mindfulness, and that's heartfulness. And that is looking at one's heart meanwhile to make sure that the heart is calm, the heart is full of love and full of light. So as we proceed today, we're going to be listening to our Sheikh with mindfulness and heartfulness and taking the lessons that we will learn from him today and apply it to today's world for us and this week's world. We are very, very honored to have our resident Atlanta scholar and imam and Sheikh Muhammad bin Yahya al-Nanawi. He is based in Metro Atlanta. Sheikh has been named as one of the 500 influential Muslims all over the world. He is also an author, an inspiration, a teacher, an imam, and a beloved member of our community. Sheikh Nanawi, good morning, assalamu alaikum, and we look forward to hearing from you.
Good morning, Sumaya. Alaikum salam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. It's very nice again to be sharing the platform with ISP Atlanta, a leader, and Sister Sumaya's leadership and contribution to the community. Good morning to everyone, and alhamdulillah, we are blessed to be here today. I would like to talk real quick in the next few minutes about the two things that are common today, and we're struggling to bring them together. Faith and fear. And many people have been spun into a paranoia about the coronavirus simply because of the news that we're hearing every single day. The media and everyone is just glued at their phone and at their TV sets and looking at numbers and analyzing. We've all become sort of epidemiologists and biostatisticians over the past time. Obviously, there's fear. Some of that fear is justified, and some of it produces excess anxiety that hurts more than helps. And I think it's very important to go and reflect sometimes on what Allah Azza wa Jal said. For example, in the Quran, Allah Azza wa Jal says, أَلَيْسَ اللَّهُ بِكَافٍ عَبْدَهُ وَيُخَوِّفُونَكَ بِالَّذِينَ مِنْ دُونَهِ. Isn't the Creator, isn't the all-loving Creator sufficient for His creation? But they're trying to scare you or to make you fear other than Him. And it's important on one hand to have the precautions taken rather than having a fear of the creation or a fear in a sense of other than Him. And therefore, it's important to realize from the prophetic teaching of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that he's always taught us not to worry about tomorrow. Tomorrow will come with its own worries and with its own things. Each day has its own planning and each day has its own provisions. And the Muslim or the person of faith, regardless, they say, ibn waqtihi, which means is the child of the moment, is the son of the moment, is the daughter of the moment, and living that moment rather than missing out on the present by either being in the past or by being fearful of the future. And therefore, it's important to speak to the heart of fear with faith and come back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, come back to the Creator. Subhanahu wa ta'ala, to be sober-minded with the love of the Creator, to attend to your daily activities and daily lives and master them and produce and make them well. And obviously to take precautionary measures and practice preventative medicine as well as much as we can. When we choose to quarantine ourselves or sort of like the way we're living today, it should not be out of fear. It should be quite out of the opposite, out of hope in the Creator, who has He, subhanahu wa ta'ala, the world has seen so many things, worse and better, and etc. And they've always come through with his help. So there has to be something that we can actually deal with this fear. And I think it's faith. Faith can actually mitigate fear into hope, mitigate fear into love, mitigate fear into hospitality, mitigate fear into positive contribution. Faith is very important now. And I think one of the things that strikes me in the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he says, for example, in Surah Al-Baqarah, أَمْ حَسِبْتُمْ أَن تَدْخُلُوا الْجَنَّةِ, or you thought you're going to just enter Jannah, وَلَمَّا يَأْتِكُمْ مَثَلُ الَّذِينَ خَلَوْا مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ, and you haven't heard about the experiences, the trials, and the hardships, and the tests of those before you. مَسَّتْهُمُ الْبَأْسَاءُ وَالضَّرَّاءُ, they were touched by hardship and by difficulties and by pains. وَزُلْزِلُوا, and they were shaken. Hatta yaqula, so much shaken, so much. Hatta yaqula ar-rasulu walladhina amanu ma'ahu mata nasrullah, until the messenger and those who believed with him, they say, when will the relief from Allah, the creator of all, comes? Allah answers, ala inna nasrallahi qareeb, indeed the relief from Allah is close. So it's very easy to think about fear and not very much about faith. But the Quran actually calls us not only to be bold, but to believe boldly in the midst of crisis. And our crisis couldn't have been more difficult than the crisis of Moses, Musa, Jesus, Isa, and Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa ajma'in. May Allah be pleased with all of them. May Allah's peace and blessings be with all of them. With this, I think the prophetic character shows. Today, people want to, there's a tension, there's a direction of, let's say, withholding. There's a direction that people take of in closing up on themselves. There's a lot of things fear is doing to people. And I think faith can undo all of that. That's when you saw the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam most hospitable when people were withholding. When you saw examples of when people were poor, that's when he was giving out most. That's when you saw the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam also with social responsibility, ensuring that the authority comes only from the creator of all. And we're all working in that framework. Responsibility to the creator versus vis-a-vis the creator, responsibility vis-a-vis the creation, and obviously responsibility vis-a-vis the self. I think it's important to look at the times of drought, the times of difficulty that the Prophet and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam's family and the companions faced. We see similar things. Today, I think one of the most important things is to go back and plug ourselves into that faith that will actually give us the strength that we need to imbibe and imbue strength and actually to channel it on to others. There is what has we have been told by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, what missed you wasn't going to hit you, and what hit you wasn't going to miss you. It's circumstance and coincidental events in the view of a faithful person are decreed eternally. So one works with that, realizes that, and takes strength from that. I leave you with that, with these thoughts. May the creator of all be with you, and you have a lovely and a wonderful day. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Sheikh Nanawi, thank you so much. And we need to believe boldly in the midst of fear and be plugged into our faith tradition to be able to face the world and be better people during this pandemic. Thank you so much for your amazing words, uplifting words, positive words. And I have to tell you, I'm ready to take on the world this morning. So thank you again. And we look forward to seeing all of you tomorrow, God willing. And Sheikh Nanawi, thank you. You have a great day, sir.
Thank you.